Today we'll be looking at some Neovim plugins to improve your productivity and workflow. We'll look at 5 powerful and useful Neovim plugins you can quickly install and configure to take your editor to the next level with a bit of a more casual format. It's important to note that this video won't cover basic Neovim configuration, such as setting up your preferred distribution, tree sitter, or language server protocol functionality. You can check out my video showcasing AstroEnvim for that, which also covers how to install plugins with the Lazy Package Manager. However, you can use other package managers like Packer to install the plugins we'll be reviewing. The first plugin we'll be looking at is Envim Surround. It adds an easy way to add, remove, or change surrounding delimiters. This means wrapping a word or selection with parentheses, quotes, brackets, and more. You can even change surrounding HTML tags with a few keystrokes. This plugin has 3 modes of operation: YS for use around, CS for change surrounding, or DS for delete surrounding. Let's start with YS, which is followed by a motion, then a delimiter. For example, if we want to surround a word with quotes, we can do YS followed by W for word and quotes. We can then repeat this to surround the word again. If we want to surround around the quotes, we can do YS, A quotes for around quotes, followed by parentheses. Alternatively, we can do a visual selection, then do uppercase S and another delimiter to surround our selection. The next functionality we'll be looking at is DS for delete surrounding. Here, to delete the surrounding braces, we can do DS braces, and you'll see that it removes them. We can also repeat this with DS parentheses to remove the parentheses as well. Next is CS for change surrounding. This works by providing the old delimiter to remove and giving it a new delimiter to replace it with. For example, we can do CS double quotes followed by single quotes to change the quote type here. Envim Surround also supports HTML using the T motion. For example, using CS T, we can replace the HTML tag around. We can also do DS T to remove the surrounding tag. The last functionality we'll be looking at is functions. If we do YS for use around followed by W for word, then F for function, we can type a function name to wrap around a selection. We can also do CSF and change the function name. Or do DSF to delete the function. Here's the configuration for the plugin. With Lazy, we can use the Very Lazy event to load the plugin on startup. You can also use the Astro community repo shown here, which should work for anyone using Lazy, even if they're not using Astro. The next plugin is called TreeJ, and provides a simple way to split or join blocks of code like arrays, objects, functions, and more. It uses TreeSitter under the hood and works by calling the TSJ toggle command to toggle splitting and joining. For example, to split this object over multiple lines, we can call TSJ toggle. We can then run it again to join it back. This also works for arrays and functions. And here's a configuration for TreeJs, which binds leader M to our TSJ toggle command. It also provides the TSJ split and TSJ join commands. The next plugin is Envim BQF, or Better Quick Fix. It adds many additions to the quick fix list. As a recap, the quick fix list is a list that shows up when using COpen. You can close it with CClose. How I like to populate the list is by searching in Telescope and using Ctrl-Q to send the results to the quick fix list. Once the plugin is installed, you will be able to see a preview of the highlighted item. In the regular quick fix list, pressing Enter goes to the result. But with this plugin loaded, pressing O will also close the list. Additionally, you can press Tab to select items in the list, then press ZN to create a list with only those items. Or you can press Tab to select some items, then press Z uppercase N to create a new list without the selected items. It also provides a way to filter in the quick fix list using ZF if you have FZF installed. This plugin can do a lot more. Take a look at its documentation, linked in the description, as all plugins are. And finally, here's the configuration for Envim Better Quick Fix. Sometimes, it's nice to be able to blame someone else for a piece of code. Our next plugin is perfect for that, and it's called Git Blame. This plugin simply adds the Git Blame information to the current line, similar to Git Lens on VS Code. It also adds a few useful commands, such as git blame open commit URL, which automatically opens the commit URL under the cursor. or git blame open file URL, which opens the file at the latest revision. You can also use the git blame copy SHA to copy the commit ID, or git blame copy file URL to copy the file URL. And here's the configuration for git blame. It also supports changing the git blame text format. And our final plugin is Trouble. Trouble shows a pretty list of diagnostics, references, or telescope results. It uses the LSP as a source of information, so it should work with any language you have set up. You can open it with a Trouble command. Here, we can see a list of diagnostics in the current file. We can press Enter to visit one. We can then use the Trouble toggle command to hide the panel. Trouble comes with many modes. By default, we use the Document Diagnostic mode. We can use Workspace Diagnostics to show problems across all our open files. In the Trouble panel, we can use ZA to fold some files. We can also use Trouble LSP references to show a pretty list of all the references of a symbol under the cursor. This plugin can also convert a quick fix list to a Trouble list. For example, if we bring up references in Telescope, then send it to the quick fix list with Control Q, then close it, we can then use Trouble quick fix to show a Trouble list. And to close it off, here's the configuration used. Since there's multiple key mappings, we can set a prefix, here leader X. Again, you can use Astro Community to install the plugin, which includes the same configuration shown here. And that's it for today. I hope you found these plugins useful and incorporate them into your workflow. Let me know which NeoVim content you'd like to see in the comments. Thank you for watching. If you enjoyed this content, please consider subscribing for more videos like this.